Those dynasties built many of the city's landmarks, and although their power dwindled after the Renaissance, there are a number of grandiose families who cling on to their noble heritage.
It's very imposing, isn't it?
It's a big villa. It's like Aston Villa. It's football club. It's massive.
We have a very special audience with Pietro del Bono, whose roots go back to the 14th century.
Buongiorno.
Good morning.
How are you? Did you have a safe trip?
Yes,
thank
we
you,
did.
Pietro.
Thank you,
thank you very much.
Why don't you come in and,
thank you.
And relax inside?
Thank you.
Pietro's family own three palatial houses in this region. This one, just north of Milan, is worth an estimated 10 million euros.
You see portraits of the family.
So many portraits everywhere, all your ancestors. Is that you?
This is me, that's me. My sister with her two elder sons, my wife. She hates that painting,
does
actually.
Does she? She looks beautiful.
Yeah, she thinks the legs are too much out, whatever. I don't know, she doesn't like it, so it's here.
So what is your title?
My title is Count. My family comes from Parma, which is famous for the Parmesan cheese, the prosciutto, the tortellini, these kind of things.
And do you still use that title?
No, I never use it.
Noble titles were officially abolished in 1948 when the Republic booted out the monarchy. So although many still use them, the titles are in fact meaningless.
As aristocracy today, do you feel your time is up? It's over?
Absolutely, yes. But it's over the old aristocracy, I would say, these titles. Now there's a new aristocracy. I would say it's fashion, it's money, it's banking. So you just have to move on and change. The new aristocracy always tried to get married into the old one in order to have the titles and maybe to have these houses, which we cannot afford any longer, but they can keep up.
So it's a good union.
It's a good use. Uh-huh.
So you can kind of buy class in Italy then?
I believe you can do that in England too, if we see the last wedding you had a month ago. So yes, you can, I would say.
Well, we'd never try to buy ourselves into royalty.
Let me bring you to the dining room, which is, it's big.
Oh, wow.
But there is something appealing about having a family crest.
I have to face that decision soon, what to put on my coat of arms.
Camera maybe, or a TV, you're holding, or yourself holding a TV.
Satellite dish.
A satellite dish.
Satellite dish, yeah. An aerial, yes.
Something like that.
I think that's really classy.
This magnificent room, apparently, is full of secrets.
This room, there are two hidden doors. I don't think you can find them.
We just have to guess where they are.
Yeah, you just have to touch them. Getting closer and closer. Almost there, yeah.
I'm scared of falling through.
This one.
Oh!
There's this one here. If you just push it a little bit, stronger, and it opens. And it leads into the kitchen.
Go in there. Oh, it leads to the kitchen.
Back to the kitchen, yeah.
You go in there, darling. You go in. Bye-bye. Nice seeing you.
Adios. All like this.
It's like the Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Shall
this
I hope?
Is the witch.
So let me walk you upstairs.
There's only one downside to owning a huge villa like this. The upkeep costs a fortune.
This is a fresco. This is probably 1,200, I would say.
And Pietro, like so many of the landed gentry, can't afford it.
Do you and your family actually use the villa?
We haven't used it for the past 40 years, I must say. Until the late 70s, we used it. But then after that, no, we just let it. We are lucky because we inherited many houses, but it's a business now. In order to live them, you have to rent them. So what's we do?
For anyone who would want to live the life here, to see how the other half lives, how much would it cost per week?
This house, between 10 and 15,000 euros, which is not that much.
Do we get a discount now?
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely, absolutely.
Peering into the exclusive world of Milan's super-rich has been eye-opening. But we haven't finished yet.